after World War II, a new eugenics was resurrected out of the bones and ashes of the old eugenics. The eugenics movement has been at the forefront to establish a new scientific racism that justifies oppression and exploitation and racism.
De facto, o racismo é inseparável das raízes da psiquiatria.
The entire history of psychiatry, beginning with scientific conclusions that were made in the 1830s, was an effort to prove the intellectual inferiority of African Americans.
Benjamin Rush is the father of modern psychiatry, and he is the one that gave us the term negritude. He said that all blacks have inherited this disease, and this particular disease, it caused them to be inferior. In addition to that, it was the reason why it was very important that blacks remain segregated and separate from whites so that whites did not inherit this disease.
Ao afirmar que a negridão era uma forma de lepra, Rush justificou a segregação como uma necessidade médica, e isso tornou-se um argumento para continuar a escravatura.
The fact that you have brutalized a whole group of people had nothing to do with that. It had everything to do with some genetic link, and that basically you are just a diseased person. So when a slave master wanted to get rid of a recalcitrant slave, they could just say, oh, well, they're suffering from this disease.
Dreptomania, that is the name of the mental disorder that was contrived by Samuel Cartwright, who said that blacks have a mental disorder if they had a desire to run away from slavery.
Running away became such a common problem that psychiatrists attempted to give that a disease. He says, but that's a cure for that. And the question was, well, what's the cure for that? Frequent whippings. You'd be surprised how that disease clears up when the lash is put in place of their excuses.
Depois da escravatura ter sido abolida, o racismo psiquiátrico não só persistiu, mas intensificou-se. O American Journal of Psychiatry proclamou oficialmente que os negros, sendo descendentes de selvagens e canibais, eram deficientemente preparados para a civilização superior, enquanto a sua pseudociência de eugenia aumentava as suas atividades racistas.
There is a clear and long and intimate connection between the eugenics movement and the Ku Klux Klan. Harry Lachlan, who was the Carnegie Institution's director of the Eugenics Record Office, had close relationship to the Ku Klux Klan through the publication of a book called White America, which was written by a major Klan leader. So Lachlan wrote a glowing review of the book in the Eugenics News. And at the same time, you have the Ku Klux Klan using eugenics to justify their racist goals.
Mas o racismo psiquiátrico não era exclusivo dos Estados Unidos. Alguns dos piores abusos do século XX aconteceram na África do Sul, onde o governo adotou as mesmas teorias e práticas racistas utilizadas por Hitler. Isto não foi coincidência. O primeiro-ministro havia estudado eugenia como aluno de psicologia na Alemanha dos anos 20, influenciada por nazismos.
Dr. Heinrich Verwoerd is regarded as the architect of apartheid. He saw South Africa as a divided state with whites, blacks and brown people living in totally separate areas, with black people having no rights whatsoever.
Com o apartheid implementado, os psiquiatras estabeleceram hospitais mentais por todo o país, que de facto não eram mais do que campos de escravos.
These places operated under a private company by the name of Smith Mitchell and Company. They were saving money through the cheap accommodation for psychiatric patients while making massive fortune out of money that Parliament had appropriated for medication. So it was a corrupt system.
Quando esta operação foi finalmente exposta, descobriu-se que 22 mil pacientes tinham morrido, enquanto ao mesmo tempo os campos psiquiátricos tinham lucrado 90 milhões de dólares. A Organização Mundial da Saúde publicou um relatório declarando que a psiquiatria cultivava o racismo e que os seus campos eram equivalentes à posse e comercialização de escravos. Em 1972, nos Estados Unidos, o psiquiatra Louis Jolly West continuou o legado do racismo da psiquiatria, idealizando uma experiência secreta de terapia de aversão chamada o Centro de Violência. O seu plano, financiado pelo governo, era implantar elétrodos nos cérebros dos homens afro-americanos e hispânicos para lhes dar choques se mostrassem qualquer comportamento violento. E se isso não funcionasse, castrá-los quimicamente com drogas. Quando a proposta racista do West enfrentou a indignação do público, o plano foi rapidamente arquivado. Embora as imparáveis teorias racistas da psiquiatria fossem neutralizadas, não foram detidas. Em 1994, o psicólogo Richard Herrnstein foi o coautor da Curva do Sino, afirmando provar que os negros eram geneticamente incapacitados e, portanto, inferiores aos brancos.
The bell curve really argues a very old eugenics idea. It argues that people are born with different kinds of intellectual abilities, that these are inborn pretty much at birth. It goes back to the notion that somehow black people are genetically and biologically inferior to white people as a way to justify what was really its programs of social racism and social sexism. And you see that kind of thinking going on in public school testing and IQ testing and educational testing and tracking.
And this new tool fit into that old mold. It was a new tool that could prove the intellectual inferiority of African Americans.
Psychiatric profession has done great damage, certainly in the past, and far too many in the present too, to subvert democracy and perpetuate racial stereotypes even more. Deep racism in society.
We have to battle against this continual misinformation, disinformation, pseudoscience. It can be repackaged in whatever form or format it is. But if it is based solely upon the color of one's skin and then is the merit of that human being, I just reject it.
E hoje a chama do ódio continua a arder, alimentada por mentiras pseudocientíficas. Este é o legado da psiquiatria, uma justificação para o racismo e pretexto para a repressão política.